now it's gone forwards.
Good thinking.
Be a while before we let you drive, Rob. Welcome on board, everyone.
Nice to have you here. I'm Rory.
Time to rock and roll.
There's Chris down the back. Big hello to Chris. I'm going to do very quick health and safety with you, as you can. Does anyone have any existing heart, back or neck conditions, as we do not recommend it? We cannot take it if you're pregnant, so nice to walk with the moment. And the last thing is about your life jackets. So keep your life jackets on and zipped up with the
Thames boat ride. All right, sit back and enjoy.
Yes, a good little guide way. Have a look around London. I've got three Londoners down the front. They'll be able to tell me loads of things. Like the name of
the London Eye.
That was very quick. Excellent. Have you been on the London Eye? Has anyone not been on the London Eye? Fair amount. Yes, yes, perfect. Best one ever. It was meant to be there for a year when they built it. Remember? Yeah, 17 years. They haven't made it any more structurally secure. Yeah, you'll get me near that, yo. So, just the time bomb, mate. To be honest, look, I'm not here to put anyone off. You're, statistically more likely to die than you are to look.
Thank you.
Just relax. Nothing. Go. It's amazing. The London Eye makes £8 million a month. Which I think is partly why it's been there for an extra 60 years. Hey, most nice. Oh, they got loads of money. You'll have to work it out. £8 million a month, 12 months a year, 17 years. Go. Come back to the camp. Here we are now, coming for bridge. From the only place in the world where you are both below and as well as you can. Right there, I've got the Hunter Bridge down at Charing Cross. I got the tube line directly underneath. It's a weird train sandwich that you can go through there. Yeah. Sounds delicious. We've got the delicious. When we come out, we can see Cleopatra's Needle. And it's the oldest outdoor monument in London. Unless the Queen is outside, in which case. It is the second oldest in the world. 3,500 years old. That's like a millennium and a half older than Jesus. That's mental. And that's like mind melting. It's only 91. Which is much older than that.
Some British humour.
I think you're right, actually. It was apparently recently, wasn't it? Thank you for that. Was really good knowledge. Now, behind me is Waterloo Bridge, which has a nickname. Does anyone know the nickname for this bridge?
Right.
Yeah, more the women's bridge, with exceptions. Because it was built by women. Right, during World War II, all the men were the only bridge in London that was built on time.
Oh, what do you expect?
And under women. I know, right? And this is selfie. Like, now, Somerset House over here has my favourite feature of any building. Can you see the top of that arch directly below the Green Dome, just above street level? So when they built Somerset House, it was before the embankment. And so the river went all the way up to the steps of the house. You were able to sail your boat in through that arch into the middle of Somerset House. Just the coolest thing ever. Can you imagine arriving to a party like that by boat? That's what you should do here. If you go fast enough, you can break the door. What are you looking at?
The
Gherkin, plus what? Well, we'll be going really close to them too. What else? The lovely, beautiful River Thames. The Thames station already. You're going to have lots of fun here soon, don't worry. Well, look, it's the cleanest city river in the world. Seriously, that's perfect. It's transparent and it's not. It's not a city river. I know. City rivers aren't clean things. It's a bit like saying, when I say it's the nicest or the cleanest city river, it's a bit like saying the kind of best English rugby team. It's not a mark of quality. It's just that one of them has to be the best. Oh, sorry, I mean, it's like saying the worst Irish rugby team. None of them are that bad. Oh, no, stop. Where are you? Sharks? God, you're brave. Have you been up to Sharks? Tell me this. Are you seen the new one of Black Friday? Yeah, that's a funny one. Loads of people point that out. It's just it's an apartment block.
It seems like it's got a really big apartment.
I hate to contradict you. It's the slowest it'll be.
Oh my God.
It's been there, it's been under construction for over 3 years. It's under, I don't know why they're being so slow. I think it's like they're doing one pane of glass every day. Yeah, really. It looks like they've got between fresh and saltwater Thames. And this is quite nicely in the columns. At the top of the columns, you've got birds carved in, and all of these birds are freshwater birds. And all of the corresponding birds are seabirds. So from now on,
which is really nice.
It basically tells you which area of the Thames you're in. Now obviously rivers don't quite work like that.
So it's not just weird to buy. You're not going to get something just for sure. But as I contribute that to the final thing.
Now as we look through Blackfriars Railway, lots of walls dominate. So design symbols
key. The Christopher Wren.
Christopher Wren. He's a legend, remember that name. His original plan was, instead of a cross on top of the dome, he wanted a 60-foot pineapple. Just for the utter crack. Yeah. Pineapple. Now, the church said no. Did not do that. Because, anyone? Jesus didn't die in a pineapple, is the answer. I'm shocked you don't know that. It's basic logic. He died in the cross. However, this is where it becomes a legend.
Yeah, I answered that question.
He was like, grand. No cross.
The Shard is my hotel tomorrow, Shangri-La.
Two towers on the left-hand side, can you see those? Those golden orbs on top are pineapples. You got them there in the end. So good. He lived to be 91. He's one of the only men, if not the only person, who designed a cathedral and then lived to see it completed. He is remarkable. On the far side, we've got Shakespeare's Globe. It's the Globe Theatre. That's a replica from 1997. The original Globe is on the far side of the Southern Green. That burned down in 1613 because Shakespeare's plays are so boring. There's a direct effect. So Shakespeare, as you'll learn, wrote many books. One of them, Henry VIII, was so boring, even Shakespeare thought it was boring. That is so many levels. Now, what he did was, because he was like, this isn't going to sell very well, I'm going to make it more exciting. And he added in like loads of fights and battles and guns and cannons at the last minute. And on the first night, a cannon backfired, set fire to a wooden post, and the entire theatre burned down in half an hour. Decimated. Right here. Now, if he'd written a good play to start with,
is all it's in.
Could have avoided that mess. What is nice, I'm obviously very fit. We've got his local pub still here. And so this is one of London's oldest pubs. Shakespeare's ranked there. Samuel Pepys has got a castle in it. Watched the last night fire in London from that pub. Has written about being a giant. It's now actually a nice place for fish and chips. It's only like 11 quid a pint, so. Now behind me is London Bridge, which is the most underwhelming thing you're going to see all weekend, unless you're seeing England playing the cricket tomorrow.
I'm going.
Are you going?
Yeah, I got tickets to Lords, mate.
Although I think we got better a couple of years ago, didn't we, comparatively.
Then they
covered Christmas, right? Oh, is that what all the best places are? Oh, yeah, absolutely. There's no, I don't think there's any less. There's a guy, I remember there's a guy in my year in school who played for Leinster. It's like the regional thing when he was 12. He wasn't that good at cricket, like. What's that? Would you look at us? And the Shards. Have you guys been to Shards?
I'm
going to die. No way. What's this bit? Yes, excellent work. You can all stay in the boat. So there's the apartments at Blackfriars. There's apartments in the Shards, starting at 30 million. That'll get you a two bedroom, like the size of a two bed semi. Going up to 50 million.
How big are going up, honestly? That's actually 20 million.
And they've sold one.
So far, the last 4 years, one has been sold.
Yeah. It's all owned by
it's owned by the Qatar Government Investment Corporation.
There are a couple of this ship here.
Yeah.
Oh, that's City Hall. No, no, City Hall behind the big circular building.
What's that
ship called? The HMS Belfast. Yes. Yeah. It's an amazing. It was the best ship. Gee, have you been on there?
Speed limit in the city. Time to fly.
Once we get up around the corner, past the police station. Now, if during the speed there's an emergency or something like that, you need assistance, raise a hand. Okay, I'm down the back with Chris. If we see a hand go up, Chris will stop the boat. I'll come to the front. You can explain to the rest of the boat why you made a shot. Two hands. Don't do absolutely nothing. Just keep going. One hand will stop the boat.
See you at Greenwich, yeah? Time to fly.
What's faster?
Marty?
What's faster?
What's faster? We go as fast. More fun, lean with the boat. Chris.
Are you happy with those three?
Right. You hold on. You have to have some other audience. We can link arms. No, link arms like this. Yeah. And you guys keep your arms through here.
Okay. Alright, boys and girls, time to fly.
Emergency exits! Everyone! The main thing is have fun.
It's Chris's first day. So before you do it, you're going to be
careful. I'm going to get a phone. So sit back, have fun, a little bit of music, and we'll see you shortly down the ground. Okay? Happy?
Happy. Alright, man, put it down, let's go. Lewis, eat your heart out, man. There, go, come on. Yeah. as this, brilliant. Where do I find people?
See here is the old naval college. In the middle you got the Queen's House, which is an amazing building. It was built for Queen Anne of Denmark, who loved living down here. She's like, when they came to build this, it was actually a hospital. She's like, yeah, go ahead, lads. Build away, but I'm not losing my view on the river. So I had to split the building in two.
Thank you. to climb up the M2 now. You've seen me on the Emirates cable car just coming up, yeah? Come on, man, go faster. Barrier Reef, and it's cold, it's bloody cold, yeah, Thames Barrier Reef, end of the ride. cruising back to Westminster. Going back to the hotel. Bloody good. £50 well spent. £50 for this ride. Money well spent. Margaret Thatcher did that. Margaret Thatcher, Prime Minister. Any further will be in France. I didn't bring my passport either.
Back in London, yeah.
Kind of extra clever about that is that it allows them to. You're very welcome. Just for your birthdays. Sorry? Exactly. Birthday, all of us on this boat,
yes,
to Manny and Robert. All right, on the count of three, as loud as humanly possible. One, two, three.
Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday to you!
For a swim.
Do you want me to take a photo for you? Do you want me to give me phones or cameras and I'll take them off?
Saw the bridge opening then, yeah, it's got that on.
So these not only have a beautiful picture of Fantastic and also give you 20% off any future trips.
Wait a second. Right,
I have two, so...
So...
Can I have four balls like that one?
It gives you a list of all our trips as well on the ground.
Oh, I'm sorry. I keep on dropping my chips. Don't tell my oh, sticker. Absolutely brilliant.
There's a link for a trip advisor. Mention Chris as well, if it is.
So welcome back to London, people. Yeah, I managed to get the planned activities in, which was going on the London Eye and that rocket boat ride, which is absolutely brilliant. Yeah, if you do one thing in London, do that. Absolutely great. You go all the way to the Thames Barrier reef at speed and come back, as you can hear from. Alright, so I was going to show you Piccadilly and Leicester Square, yeah? Alright. Talk on this, I think the Millennium Bridge. Jubilee Bridge, rather. Jubilee Bridge towards Charing Cross. Show those two spots. Leicester Square, Piccadilly Circus. We walk back to the Hotel Intercontinental. So we've seen a full 360 degree loop around the city.
Hier op drukken, ja, er even bij zijn waar je.